The good news for Tondrell Durham's Top Drink McGinnis team was that they were playing in the state final for a second straight season. But the bad news was they were matched up with the team that won the gold ball last year, number 2 Tulsa Memorial. McGinnis big man Will Linhard tied for team scoring honors with 19 points, as that was the same total that Brian Canfield ended up with after the senior was true from three-point land. Stephen Amalong hurried down court for the layup for the Irish before Memorial's Damari Edwards had the tough drive for 2 of his 12 points. The Chargers led 23-21 at halftime. After the break, R.J. Diggs hit the floater as R.J. led all scorers in this game with 20 points. With just over 3 minutes to play, Bobby Allison saw A.J. Cockrell battle inside for the putback and foul. That gave Tulsa Memorial a lead that they would never lose. Mike Juan Dean later had the steal in layup as the Chargers won their second straight state title and their 6th in school history.
Same team, the rematch of last year's championship game. I mean, same outcome. We just played hard.
It's an indescribable feeling, the pride that I feel, the happiness for the kids because they put in a lot of work, the happiness for the coaching staff. But to go back-to-back is an unbelievable accomplishment. It's so awesome that these kids get to experience this, and I hope they take these lessons and take this, what all the good things that make a championship team, from patience, love, hard work, to togetherness and trust, and they've turned that into great lives. I mean, that's what it's all about.
Deer Creek surprised everyone last year when Totsie Manning's team won the Class 5A girls state title, and their third-ranked Lady Antlers were right back in the final this year, matched up with number 2 Tulsa East Central. The Creek's Dakota Van was incredible in this one, with a drive and layup as Dakota led the Lady Antlers with 17 points and 17 rebounds. 6'3", Shayrayla Brown took the pass from Ashlyn Mead and hit the sweet shot off the glass for Sammy Mack's club, and later it was Janine Arnold with the slick layup. Arnold had 16 points while Brown ended the afternoon with 12 for the Lady Cardinals. This game went into overtime, tied at 23, and that was when Deer Creek's Whitney Jones found Bailey Blanchard for the jumper. The Creek was up by 3 with time running out, but East Central couldn't get a shot off before the final buzzer. Deer Creek has now won 2 straight Class 5A state titles, and it's the 5th overall time that the Lady Antlers have claimed the top prize.
It's surreal, really. It's crazy. It doesn't feel real. It didn't feel real last year. It doesn't feel real this year. And 2 times in a row is hard to do, you know. Not a lot of teams do that. So I think we proved ourselves. There was a lot of doubt, and we proved ourselves. So
at the beginning of the season, I don't think we thought we would be here 0-2, but we just worked really hard, and we knew we could do it. So just all about believing in your team and yourself.
We always rely on our defense no matter what. We might struggle a little bit on the offensive end at times, but that's because we put so much effort into our defense that, we know if we get stops that eventually we'll score buckets and we can turn those into wins. We started the season 0-2, and we reminded our kids of that. Look where we're at today because of all the hard work that you had. We actually were 500 right at Christmas time. So we put in the work. The girls put in the work, and I said, nobody's going to outwork us, and we're going to fix those things we need to fix because we want to defend our state championship.